So here we are on what is a key milestone. I mean, it's so exciting. We've got, 70,000 volunteers we need to make these games happen. Are we going to get them?
We will. Big moment. But we will. We've got about 250,000 that we're able to sift through. Mm-hmm. And about 50,000 for the Olympic Games, about 20 for the Paralympic Games, and a whole range of roles and responsibilities. Mm-hmm. You know, some generalists, some specialists. The interviews here tomorrow will start focusing on our medical services, mm-hmm. and that's quite technical, but it won't be long before we're trying to figure out who the people are that are going to be driving, meeting and greeting at airports, all those sorts of things.
Mm-hmm. Now, when organisers came forward and said we need 70,000 people, did anyone on the organising committee think this is never going to happen, or were you always sure that people were going to come forward and put this time?
We were always pretty sure. Mm-hmm. I personally, you know, I'm standing here doing this interview as a product of volunteers at an extraordinary extent in my own sport. Mm-hmm. You know, I was coached by volunteers. I ran for an athletics club in London that was based out there and peopled by volunteers. I mean, everything I've ever done has been about volunteers. So I don't have any doubts at all about how deep the spirit of volunteering runs in all our communities. And yes, we will get the right people. And yes, we need 70,000.
And from your experience in a past Olympics, how important are these kind of games makers that they're being called?
I think I've said on a number of occasions, but you know, I've been very privileged. I've competed in the games twice. I've worked as a broadcaster, as a writer. I've worked within an International Olympic Committee commission. I'm now the vice president of an international federation. I've bid for games, and I'm now helping inside a team to deliver one. Every time I look at the games, I look at the way they work, the successful games and the less successful games. Normally, the defining ingredient are the volunteers.
Mm-hmm. What do you want from a volunteer? Just a can-do attitude, if they're not the kind of technical side of it, as you say, the medical. What do you need from them?
I want volunteers that want to be there, which is helpful. Mm-hmm. And I know we have. I mean, every time I talk to potential volunteers, they're excited by this process. I know that from games I've been to. And I think I want people who really want to be a part of the history. They want to be able to look back and say, I didn't compete in London. I wasn't working within the organising committee, but I made a difference. I made the difference between these games being a good games and a great games.
And what kind of people do you find you've had come forward to volunteer? Older, younger, you know?
Right across the board. Right across the board. Mm-hmm. You know, we want the volunteers to reflect the city and the country that we're staging the games in exactly the same way the organising committee does. We take diversity very seriously.
And can you believe we're so close? I remember standing in Stratford, you know, we've got the Olympics in 2012, and here we are a mere 18 months away.
It's next year. That's the sobering thought. The games are next year, and when we all wake up on January the 1st, next year, it'll be this year.
Is it exciting or overwhelming?
No, it's exciting. It's exciting, but I think we all recognise we have a huge responsibility to deliver this in a way that makes people proud.